Hi, it's Matt here from Go Green Autos. So I've got my Tesla back. This has just had a new 85 kilowatt hour traction battery fitted under the drivetrain warranty. So in this video, I'm just going to go and drive to a supercharger to see if the charging speeds are any different. So this is a Model S 2014. It's now 7.5 years old and has done 101,000 miles. And this has just had a new traction battery fitted. I only picked it up yesterday. And before, I was getting absolutely terrible supercharging speeds. Like the last supercharge I did, I think I was only at sort of 20% battery and I was only getting 20 kilowatt charging. So I know on these, obviously, they're throttling back the charging rates on the older cars to preserve battery life, and a lot of customers are unhappy with that. Mine seem to be much worse, so I'm hoping that's because the battery was failing, and indeed the battery did fail. So it's now got a new battery, well, a reconditioned, well, they call it a remanufactured battery pack. That was just fitted last week. It hasn't been supercharged yet. I only picked the car up yesterday. So my battery is currently at 41% there. I've navigated into the navigated to the nearest superchargers, which are at Oxford. And when I get there, the battery will be at 29%. So not particularly low. I'm not going to do a full charge. I just want to see what sort of speeds I am getting and whether they're going to be any quicker with this new pack or whether I'm going to see the same terrible charging speeds. So before I pull away, I'll just tell you the outside temperature is 12 degrees at the moment. We can see up there that the battery preconditioning has started. So what that's doing is charging. It's heating the battery pack up as we drive. So when we get to the superchargers, the battery is at optimum temperature to take a fast charge. So the drive is half an hour, 33 minutes away, and it's 19 miles. So I'll next see you when I'm plugged in at the superchargers at Oxford Services. So I've just plugged in, and wow, it is charging so much better than my old pack was. At this sort of battery percentage, we're at 28%. Of course, it shows you there as well. Anyway, we're at 28%, and it's jumped up to 80 kilowatt. Before, I was seeing 20, 22, 18. That sort of speed. Okay, my pack did then fail, so clearly the pack had problems. But anyway, if you don't know, these cars are throttled back. It should be seeing, I don't know, 120, I think, on an old model like this. But, you know, 75 kilowatt, I'm happy enough with that. Little side note, one thing I do like about the Tesla charging network is it's just clever and smart. So here at Oxford, and it is busy, there are 8 stalls free. You know, still good, because you go on the other side of the car park where the other public chargers are, there's only 2 chargers anyway. So having 8 stalls free on this side, it would just be a dream if you had 8 stalls of DC rapid charging on the other side for everyone else to use. But anyway, even though there's still 8 free, well, 7 free now because I've just pulled up. It says up here on the car, high usage supercharging station, charging set to 80%, adjust time if needed. So what that does is when supercharging locations are busy, it automatically drops the cars down to 80% charge to make people disconnect sooner and get on with their journeys, which frees up the location, frees up the superchargers. It's just really clever and makes complete sense to allow more people to get here and charge. as they are saying that, someone is filming me while I'm filming the car. That's the other thing you get with here, particularly at Oxford. You have a line of superchargers and people drive past and stop and stare and look, which is great because they're just seeing that electric cars work, and it's quite an impressive sight seeing a line of Teslas charging on a line of superchargers. And that woman has just drove past and gone now. They'd slowed down and was filming it. So I looked up and she was filming me while I was filming this. But anyway, yeah, it just works so well. And that's what you get when the chargers are owned by the same manufacturer as the car, and it's all just so well integrated. So we're at 71 kilowatt. I'm happy with that. I know a lot of people wouldn't be, but this is an old car. It's certainly performing an awful lot better than it was on the old battery pack. I'm going to walk in, use the loo, grab a coffee. That's the other thing with electric cars, you do drink an awful lot of coffee. I'll go and do that and come back and see what the charging rate is like as it starts filling up the pack. One nice thing about Tesla charges is the cars aren't here very long. There's two cars left. A Model 3 is just pulling in, but a few minutes ago there were four or five cars there. And then looking on this side, I don't know, there's one, two, three, four up there or so. But yeah, some spaces. Cars aren't here too long, particularly the Model 3s. You can look here 1 minute, it was pretty full when I went to the loo, came back, sat in the car, within a few minutes, about four or five cars all left at the same time. So I've got my coffee, jumped back in. We're now at 50% state of charge and the charging rate has dropped down to 60 kilowatt. So not great, but it's certainly a lot better than I was experiencing before. I know Model 3 owners will be looking at that thinking, Jesus, that's terrible. But anyway, we know that these old cars are throttled back to preserve the battery pack. I'm happy enough with that because, as I said previously, I was getting much, much lower speeds, obviously because the battery was on its way out and had issues anyway. There's clearly a difference between my old pack and the new pack. So if I've got those sort of speeds, then yeah, generally I'm happy enough with that. So I think that will probably do for this video. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please do click the thumbs up on YouTube. Do subscribe if you haven't. If you haven't liked this, do click thumbs down. I really don't mind. Any interaction is good interaction on YouTube. Do comment below if you've got anything to say or want to ask anything about this car. And more videos coming soon.